Thank you for joining me on Word of Inspiration. This is the day that the Lord has made. Rejoice and be glad in it. Take your mind away from all the noise that surrounds you and focus on Him and give Him praise, because God has good plans in store for you. Jeremiah 29 verse 11 says, "For I know the thoughts that I have concerning you, thoughts of peace and not evil, to give you an expected end." God wants to give you an expected end. Today, this is Dr. Bertha Aye, and I have a message for you I've entitled, Relationships Matter to God. And my hope is that by the end of this message, you will reevaluate your relationships, see where someone has offended you, and that you will try to reconcile with that person. My text is taken from the book of Matthew, chapter 5, verse 22, and Jesus simply says, "But I say this unto you, he who is angry with his brother without a cause, shall be in danger of judgment, and he who calls his brother Raka shall be in danger of being brought to the council, and he who calls his brother a fool shall be in danger of hellfire." Prior to that, Jesus had said, "For you have heard it said, thou shalt not kill, for he who kills shall be in danger of judgment." Killing someone is the worst expression of hatred. It means you want the person gone, away from this earth completely. But Jesus said, although that's the extreme form that gets punished, even in the law courts of today, just being angry towards someone is enough. He said it's equal to even killing the person. Anger is a strong emotion that arises within people when someone has offended you or crossed the line or done something to hurt you. I agree, some people get angry easier than others because they have more boundaries that they don't want anybody to cross. Some people get angry less often, but needless to say, anger is an emotion that Jesus said can put you away from God. In fact, if you read on, Jesus goes on to say that to the extent that even if you bring in a gift before God, you're ready to give God an offering, and you remember that you have offended someone, you should actually put your gift down, go and reconcile with that person, and then you bring your gift. So the goal here is reconciliation. Has someone offended you to the point where you don't want to see them? You don't want to forgive them? The book of 1 John chapter 4 verse 20 to 21 says, "He who says he loves God whom he has not seen and hates his brother whom he sees every day is a liar. For this is the commandment that we have of him, that we should love one another." Why is anger such an important thing? Because if you let it root, it leads to other things, and it can actually cause you to kill someone. That's why Jesus said, it's not just when someone kills another person, but just having anger towards another one. And a good example is Cain and Abel, the very first people who descended from Adam and Eve. They both gave an offering. Cain got upset with Abel and decided to kill him. His anger led to something else. Today, I just want you to simply search your heart. Is there somebody who has upset you in a way? In fact, that's not even a question to ask. As we go through life every day, somebody will offend you. Maybe somebody you don't even know, in traffic, at home, in your workplace. How do you deal with it? Do you choose to keep it and get angry? Now remember, the verse said, angry without cause. Does that mean if you have cause, you can keep being angry? Sometimes the people don't even know that you've offended them. Whatever it is, Jesus said, anger is almost synonymous with killing somebody. Are you angry with somebody? Has somebody hurt your feelings? Today, go to God in prayer and ask God to help you deal with it. Because Jesus also told us, if you have unforgiveness in your heart, your prayers will not be answered. It's as though when you start approaching God, all he sees is that individual that you've placed in your heart that you're angry about or not forgiving. Today, will you do that? Let us pray. Father, we thank you for your word that comes to teach us and show us how to relate to you. And one of the things you're teaching us today is that if we are angry towards somebody, we call someone a fool, we call somebody raka, empty-headed, whatever word we choose to use, it puts us in a position where we cannot come close to you. Give us the strength and the grace to forgive those who offend us. This is what we ask with thanksgiving in Jesus' name. Amen. Today, the Lord bless you and keep you. May he cause his countenance to shine upon you. May he guard your mind against anything that threatens to take away your peace, may he smile upon you and may you see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Please say these words after me. I'm more than a conqueror. Today I choose to walk in love. Today I do not have our hatred. Today I do not have our anger. Today I'm more than a conqueror. I would win over every situation that life presents to me because I'm the head and not the tail, above and never beneath. With God on my side and with Jesus on my boat, I will win. I shall not die, but I will live to declare God's goodness concerning my life. Please join me next time. This has been Dr. Bertha Ayu with Word of Inspiration. God richly bless you.